Hello everyone, this is Dihydrazino Tetrazine or DHT, a compound with a beautiful and intense red-violet color. This compound is best described as a highly energetic fuel, having a heat of formation measured at plus 536 kilojoules per mole. DHT is an example of a high nitrogen explosive that relies entirely on its heat of formation for sustaining a detonation. When ignited, it burns very energetically, somewhat similar to smokeless powder. If you touch it with a glowing splint, it instantly smolders with almost no smoke. This last characteristic makes this compound appealing for use in smokeless pyrotechnics, and I even found a few relevant articles. I'll try using it to create colored smoke. I once experimented with mixtures of DHT and dyes, and they produced very good colored smoke. I'll try to create an effect similar to my ninja smoke bomb, but with colored smoke. I think there are simpler ways, for example, a mixture of potassium chlorate and thiourea should give a similar effect, but I want to experiment with tetrazine. So let's move on to the synthesis. In this video, I'll perform two reactions. Both reactions are very simple and are carried out by simply mixing the reagents at room temperature and leaving the reaction mixture for some time for the product to fully precipitate. Since both syntheses are so straightforward, I didn't divide them into two separate videos. The first reaction is where the cyclization into dihydrotetrazine occurs. This isn't tetrazine yet, but it's very similar. For this, I take the triaminoguanidine nitrate synthesized in the previous video, suspend it in water, and add acetylacetone in small portions at room temperature with slight cooling. After adding all the acetylacetone, the mixture should be left for 24 hours at room temperature for the product to fully precipitate. The product is then filtered and washed with water. The yield is 90%. There's another method where you heat it for 4 hours at 70 degrees Celsius, but with that method, I only got a 70% yield. The second reaction consists of two reactions carried out in a single vessel. First, the dihydrotetrazine is oxidized to tetrazine, and then the pyrazole groups are substituted with hydrazine. The intermediate product, although we don't isolate it here, is interesting in itself because it's a key precursor for other high-energy tetrazine derivatives. Here are some of them. They all combine high energy density with low sensitivity. So to perform the reaction, I simply suspend dihydrotetrazine in acetonitrile and add hydrazine hydrate with a slight excess. The mixture begins to darken, which is a sign of oxidation. After a few hours, it already has a dark red color. Although the oxidation is fast for complete DHT precipitation, the mixture needs to be left for 48 hours. The product is filtered and washed with acetonitrile or alcohol, but not water because it dissolves in it. That's the entire synthesis. I've achieved yields from 85% to 95%. If my experiments with DHT and smoke yield good results, I'll make a separate video. That's all for today. Goodbye.